Hey there, welcome to video two. Today we're going to cover camera and camera settings on your phone and what you can do with paid apps like Mavis, which we use to shoot our video that you may have seen on our ad campaign and the landing page for this course. Now, depending on what phone you're using, you might have a wide range of available settings. So don't be too freaked out if what you see on your phone is different than what you see on our phone. We're going to be using an iPhone 6S, so we're a little more limited on what we can do. In the very least, you should be able to set up the quality, either 720p, 1080p, maybe even 4K, depending on your phone. Now, you can play around with what works best for you, but even if you set it to 1080p at 30 frames per second or 30 FPS, that will probably be good. Now let's see what a paid app can do. For our video, we used Mavis, which is a $20 paid app. It's only available on iOS, but for other platforms, there are a wide variety of camera apps that you could probably find something that is very similar. The great thing about paid apps is they give you a lot more functionality and give you some of the settings that you would see on a cinema-grade camera. Now, going into this, this may be a little overwhelming, but don't worry, we're going to show you what matters most. Now again, you can set it to a wide range of qualities and frames per second or FPS, but again, 1080p at either 30 FPS or 29.97 FPS, depending, is going to be just fine for great video. Next, we want to tackle the ISO. Now, unfortunately, we can't really give you an ISO setting to go with because it is so dependent on when and where you're shooting. So really, the only rule of thumb is you want to keep that ISO as low as possible to avoid noise or grain on your footage. So really, you should be trying to light the area first and then play with the ISO. To help you get that proper lightness, a lot of these camera apps have a feature called zebras. Now, zebras are little lines that show up on parts of your footage that is overlit, overexposed, and blown out, essentially. Now, a few of these zebras here and there on things that are predominantly white is okay, but if you have mass swaths of zebras, then it's time to kind of adjust your brightness and adjust that exposure. Of course, if this is all a little too daunting, you can shoot it in auto mode. Auto mode is perfectly fine. The reason we shoot it in manual though is because auto mode isn't designed to give you perfect footage, it's designed to give you decent looking footage, and you really won't have that kind of quality unless you go manual. So if you're up for the adventure, we highly encourage it. Well, that's it for today. Tomorrow, we're going to actually show you how to shoot the video, including framing the shot, audio, and lighting. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you then.